Okay, so here we are outside the world famous Trent Bridge cricket ground. What we're going to do today is we're going to show you how easy it is to get from the world famous Trent Bridge to the world famous Trent Navigation Pub for our Bales and Ales Festival ahead of next week's test match. Now, I'm joined today by a guy, only nine players have scored more runs in first class cricket for Nottinghamshire than this guy. He was the youngest player to represent the county when he first came into the side. He also scored in 1993, also scored the fastest 100 that season with just 73 balls against Glamorgan away down in South Wales. I want to welcome you to Mr. Paul Johnson. Hi Paul, thanks for joining us.
Hi guys, all right?
Yeah, very well, thanks Paul. Quick question, memories of playing here, what's your best memories of playing at Trent Bridge?
Coming through the gates first as a sort of 15, 16 year old was pretty special, coming straight from Bolton Club Cricket into the world-renowned Trent Bridge, and it was a wonderful period for me, and representing my county, walking out there for the first time was pretty special.
And scoring no fewer than 20,000 runs during that 21 year career?
Yeah, 22. But,
sorry, 22
no,
years?
Yeah, but... No, yeah, it was pretty special. Coming to an office like this for 22 years as a player and then 11 as a coach after it, was something made a dream.
And playing with some really big names as well. Who sort of stands out as the best player you played with at that time?
Well, it was a pretty special dressing room to come into as a 15, 16 year old with Rice, Hadley, Randall, Bruce French. But Richard Hadley was the Rolls Royce of them all. And probably against, I love playing against him. I love watching him. I'd pay now if he was still playing, which was Viv Richards.
Have you played against Viv here? Or?
Yeah, numerous times. Yeah, he played in that game you mentioned, the fastest 100 game, he played in that as well. So, yeah it was pretty special to show off to him on that day as well.
Excellent, very good. So what we're going to do now is we're going to show you just how easy it is to get from Trent Bridge to the Trent Navigation. So do you want to come with us? So here we are, we've just had a little bit of a stop off in the sunshine at one of our sister pubs, the Waterside Bar and Kitchen here on the wonderful Trent Bridge. And the reason we've stopped here, Paul, is because in the background, we've come from the world's best cricket ground, and in the background we've got the world's best football ground. Happy memories?
Yeah, my first game, 1974 with my dad, I think I was 9 years old, giving my age away, but my dad said, right, we're going to go and watch Duncan McKenzie play his last game for Forest Boy. Went down, Forest won 4-1, 42,000 there, hooked for life, and still going down now.
And who was that against?
Man City.
So a 4-1 win against Man City in front of 42,000.
Yeah, that was my first game. I think the result might be a little bit different these days, but anything's possible.
It might at the moment, but we can always dream, can't we?
We can.
So here we are, stood on the canal bridge. The Trent Navigation is literally 50 yards to my right. Still got Paul with me. Now, you mentioned earlier about some of the players that you played with when you first broke into that side. And there's one that strikes a chord with me because I'm only a couple of years younger than you, Paul, but Derek Randall was a hero of mine at that time. There must be a great story from our club.
Well, there's tons. I could probably speak for an hour. So, the one that makes me giggle, it's not the longest, it's not the funniest. We played in a Sunday league game down at Canterbury, and there was a lady on the boundary edge, and Derek always used to emanate to someone who's wearing a hat or someone who draw attention to themselves. And for three balls, without Ricey knowing, that Derek had swapped his sweater with a woman, and he had her sombrero on, and she had his cap on, and she fielded for three balls without anybody knowing. And he was just having a laugh and a joke with the crowd, thinking it was a normal thing to do. Ricey wasn't happy, got him back on the field within three balls. But Derek refused to change the hat, so he fielded for the rest of the game with a big sombrero. That was Derek Brown.
Absolutely brilliant. Right, shall we go to the Nav? Thank you.
fantastically created beer garden at the Trent Navigation. You've seen how close we are in proximity to the world's best cricket ground and the world's best football ground, which we passed on the way as well. We've also got the world's best brewery behind us, Navigation Brewery, where we actually brew the beer on site, which I was going to say Paul and I are going to have in a minute, but he's already started. But Paul, this is all about the Bales and Ales Festival and the fact that we can get here and you can come and have a beer and you can come and have some food during the Test match. What's your take on England in the Test Series at the moment, and or not the Test Series, but the one upcoming against England? It's going to be tough.
It's always tough. You know, they're a very strong opposition. I think England have got some questions to answer and some places to fill at the top end. I think obviously you've got Root, and I think our middle order pretty much looks after itself. Hopefully now Stokes is fit and you've got players in there. We can keep us a little bit. You know, I'd always have Johnny Bairstow ahead of Josh Butler, but you know, they'll have their thoughts on that. But it's the top three for me that probably prove the biggest concern, whether they go with Sibley, Burns and Crawley as they are, or bring in the likes of Haseeb, there's James Vince and a few others that are in and around there that are potentially pushing for those places. It would be very interesting to see which direction they go.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it, that there is the competition there now, isn't there? Because it's been a little bit, the openers have been a little bit worrying over the last couple of years.
You know, you get rid of that rock, who is Alistair Cook, and you take away such a lot of stability and sort of day-in, day-outness about it, because obviously he was captain for a period of time. You know, his run scoring record speaks for itself. And they're big boots to fill, and you know, I don't think they've necessarily done it yet. I'd probably stick with Burns, but the Sibley Crawley combination is still pretty unproven. So there's two spaces there that quite a few players have been looking to target.
And the Indians, it's going to be tough.
Always is. You know, they score runs for fun. It'll be interesting to see what wickets we prepare. I don't think there'll be many like we saw in sandpits over there. I think there'll be probably a little bit more the colour of the AstroTurf here in the beer garden at the Navi than they will be sandy brown. So it'll be interesting to see what we prepare, but they are a very strong outfit. And, if we turn these over, we'll play very, very well.
So day one of the Test, Wednesday the 4th of August here at Trent Bridge, not here at Trent Bridge, obviously here at the Trent Navigation, is our Bales and Ales Festival. Big thank you for Paul Johnson for joining us today, and I think we probably should see what this beer's all about, shouldn't we?
Cheers.
Cheers, thanks for coming.